Hello my dear students, welcome to computer science class. In today's video class, we shall discuss few of the programs related to the structures. Before we start up, let us have a quick recall on what is the definition of structure. Structure, it's a collection of simple variables of same or different data types like int, char, float. Now, just recall how do we define a structure? Defining a structure involves by providing the structure name called as tag. Previous to it, we need to start with a keyword known as struct, which indicates the beginning of the definition of a structure. Then it consists of n number of data items where the data items have been given with the name as well as its data type. The list of all these data items, we can refer it as an members of the structure, and we can even refer it as an template. Then a semicolon will be followed to the closing bracket to indicate that is the end of the structure. So this is what we had discussed in the previous class. Plus, we also have discussed about how do we initialize and how do we access the members of the structure. So we cannot directly access this feet and inches. I cannot directly read the content into the variable feet, neither I can print it directly. But what should we do? We should create a structure variable to this particular structure called as distance. So with the help of structure variable, we can able to read and print. With this help of structure variable as well as member access operator, that's a dot operator, with the help of both, we are able to access the members of the structure. Now let us discuss the program to find the sum of two distances. Now herein, and we already known that the definition of the structure should be before the main function or before any of the variables which are being declared within the main function. Now here is an example where we are defining our structure before the main function. Okay, then in our previous program example, within the after the main function, we had actually defined the structure. That was when we were discussing the program related to input and display the information of a student. There, the structure we had defined within the main function but before any variables were being declared. Now, in this program, we are defining a structure before the main function. Either of them you can follow. Now, look at here. This is a structure name known as distance, wherein it is having the members of a structure known as feet of type integer and inches of type float. Now here we need to calculate the sum of the distances. Now herein, the distance is being given in terms of feet and inches. They'll be given with the two distances, wherein you need to calculate into that the total distance, the total the both of the distance in the form of feet and inches. Now coming to the main function here, what is this actually distance followed by this d1? It's a structure variable. This is how we have created a structure variable. So how, what is the syntax to create a structure variable is the structure name followed by the variable name. Plus we have directly initialized. Isn't it initialization we have seen like this? So the distance followed by the structure variable name known as d1 is equal to, directly we are not asking the user to enter. In fact, I am just giving 5, 6.75. It is 5 is stored in the feet and 6.75 is being stored in inches. Similarly, we have created another two structure variables known as D2 and D3, which belongs to a structure known as distance. Now, these D2 and D3 are not initialized. Only D1 has been initialized. Now, I am going to ask the user to enter the values for the second distance in the terms of feet and inches. Therefore, the next statement is written as cout. Enter the second distance in feet and inches. So, here Look at this. Cn stream extraction d2 dot feet. That means whatever the first value we are going to enter in your command prompt, that will be stored in a variable known as d2 dot feet. Remember, we cannot read or we cannot print the members of the structure directly. With the help of the structure variable itself, with the help of dot operator, we are able to read. I cannot write here cn directly feet, then stream extraction inches directly. I cannot write it. You should always make use of the structure variable. As I said, second readings I will be asking the user, and those readings I'll be storing in a structure variable referring to the d2 here. That is the reason I have taken here d2 dot feet and d2 dot inches. Now we all know that 12 inches make 1 feet, isn't it? Or you can even say as 1 feet is equal to 12 inches. Therefore, first we need to calculate the sum of the inches of two distances. Okay. So, herein d1 dot inches and d2 dot inches. Whatever the d1 here, 6.75 plus what the user enters, that will be stored in the second. And it will be stored in d3 dot inches. Next, after you calculate the inches, we need to initialize the d3 dot feet. That means the sum of these two, d1 and d2 inches in terms of feet and inches, that will be stored in the new structure variable here is d3. That is the reason before we store it anything, d3 dot feet is equal to 0.0. We are initializing it. All right. Now, whatever you calculate here, d1 dot inches and d2, it is being stored in d3 dot inches, right? So, therefore, we are checking. We know the condition that 1 feet is equal to 12 inches. Therefore, I am checking whether if d3 dot inches is greater than or is equal to 12. Suppose if we got the inches in terms of 14. 14 inches cannot be, right? It should be within the 12. Then only we can refer it as an inches. Otherwise, it would be considered to be as 1 feet, isn't it? Suppose if it is 14, 14 inches is greater than 12. If so, what you need to do in the given d3 dot inches, this statement is how d3 dot inches, it's a shorthand notation children here. So it is d3 dot inches is equal to d3 dot inches minus 12.0 it is. So in the 14, I am deducting 14 minus 12.0. Then how many inches you will get here? 2 inches you will get. And I am incrementing d3 dot feet plus plus. That means initially it was 0.0. Now the feet would become 1.0. Because in 14 inches, 12 inches to be considered as 1 feet. That is the reason feet got incremented and d3 dot inches is in the sense here. 12 inches are being deducted and the remaining would be 2 inches. And finally, we are calculating the feet here. That is d1 dot feet plus d2 dot feet. Only this I cannot calculate now. But suppose if the inches is greater, already in the d3 dot we already have some value. We should also consider this also. I cannot directly write here d3 dot feet is equal to d1 dot feet plus d2 dot. Why I cannot write directly in that way? Because whatever the calculation happens in the recently, that will be stored in d3 dot feet, and d3 dot feet will erase its previous contents. Actually, d3 dot feet, 1 feet is there already, isn't it? So it will erase and it will take a new value. It should not happen in that way. So this statement, if you clearly observe, d3 dot feet plus is equals to it is. Not just is equal to, it's plus is equal to d1 dot feet plus d2 dot feet. This statement is equivalent to d3 dot feet is equal to d3 dot feet plus d1 dot feet plus d2 dot feet. So d3 dot feet first 1 plus d1 dot 5, then d2 dot feet means here the user might have entered 8 feet. So that way 1 plus 5 plus 8, then the total will be calculation will happen. Now this is how we are actually calculating the d3 dot feet. That is d3 dot feet plus d1 dot feet plus d2 dot feet. And finally, we are printing the d1 in terms of feet and inches plus d2 in terms of feet and inches. And then finally, whatever we have calculated as d3 dot feet and d3 dot inches, we have calculated that we are going to print here. Let us understand this one with the tracing here. See, I have initialize the structure variable d1 with 5 feet and 6.75 inches, and I have taken two other structure variables d2 and d3 that belongs to a structure called as distance. That is the reason I have written like this. And then when I am asking the user to enter the value for the second distance in terms of feet and inches, then the user might have entered here 10 feet and 6.85 inches. All right. So therefore, the next statement what we need to calculate is d3 dot inches. So the formula is d1 dot inches plus d2 dot inches. Now what is the d1 dot inches according to this is 6.75. That's what I have replaced here. Plus d2 dot inches. D2 dot inches is how much? 6.85. When 6.75, 6.85, when you calculate, here I'm getting 13.60 inches I'm getting. And this 13.60 is being stored in a variable that is structure variable, that is d3 dot inches. And we all know that 1 feet makes 12 inches. Now, what is the next step? Before we calculate the feet, we need to initialize the d3 dot feet is equal to 0.0. As per our program, the next step is what? Whether to check whether d3 dot inches, if it is greater than or is equal to 12, then we need to add those many inches. We need to consider it as a feet and we need to add it. We need to increment the value of the feet. So therefore, if d3 dot inches is greater than or equal to 12.0, if in that case, then you are deducting the 12 inches out of it. This is a shorthand notation as I have explained in the program. This is equivalent to, as I have written here, d3 dot inches is equal to d3 dot inches minus 12 inches. All right. So therefore, what is the d3 dot inches here? 13.60. 13.60, is it greater than or equal to 12.0? Yes, the condition is true. Since the condition is true, the very next statement will be executed here. The once it is executed, see here, I've just substituted the values here. 13.60 minus 12.0, I'll get here 1.60. So 1.60 will be there in d3 dot inches. Very soon after that, the next statement what we have, we are incrementing the value of feet, that is by 1, because all that 12 inches is being getting converted in terms of feet and it is being stored in the d3 dot feet as 1. So therefore d3 dot feet value will be 1. So these both the statements are the true part of this simple if statement. That is the reason why we have used the braces here. Then soon after that, we need to calculate the d3 dot feet here. So as I have already explained, one value is already there in this d3 dot feet. That is the reason this statement is equivalent to, as I said, d3 dot feet plus d1 dot feet plus d2 dot feet. So I have just substituted the values, already one value plus the 5. This is a d1 dot feet it is. Alright. And then the second one feet in terms of feet is 10. That's what I have substituted and I get 16 feet here. So finally, I'm going to print it. So d1 dot feet is what? 5. So this is how actually we are displaying in an output screen. Before I execute and show you the program, I just wanted to show you how we are using the cout statement in order to print all these escape sequence character, that is a colon and that is a comma and then the double comma here and all. So this is an escape sequence character. That is the reason it has been preceded with a backslash here. So d1 dot feet value is 5. And then we want this particular symbol. That is with the help of escape sequence character we have used. And fine, I even want the your dash here. I want it in this way. So I've just given it. And then followed by d1 dot inches. And then I want it in double quotes here like this. D1 dot inches is 6.75 is printed. And then we want in this particular symbol, which is again I'm using, it's an escape sequence character. And followed by a plus symbol here. Okay. So let me execute this program and show you so that you can clearly understand the usage of cout statement here. So before do that, let me execute the program for you. Now here is the same program. What we were discussing here till now. Let me compile this program. Zero errors. All right. We shall run the code. See, enter the second distance and feet in terms of inches. So here I'm going to enter it as 10 All right. And then the inches in terms of 6.85. First one already we have initialized. The second one I have given 10 feet and 6.85 inches. Look at this. First one is 5 feet. This symbol indicates it's a feet, and this symbol indicates it's inches, plus the 10 feet, 6.85 inches. Total is 16 feet. And then 1.6 inches. Actually, we got 1.60. It is considered to be as 1.6 inches. I hope, students, you are able to. Okay. Let us move on to the next topic here. That is nested structure. So, before we start with the nested structure, we know that you can have n number of structure variables. So a structure variable could be assigned to another structure variable. See here, might be already a structure called as an, you know, student has already been created. For a student, I will create a structure variable known as std1. Okay, in a student structure, I might have his name, register number, percentage. These three members of the structure, members are there of the structure known as student, and to access those members I have created one structure variable, that is std1. Now instead of again creating one more structure variable, I can directly initialize, I can assign whatever the members of structures are there, I can assign it to the another structure variable as std2. That is the same, whatever the std1 structure variable can access all the members of the structure known as student, the same members will be accessible by the, you know, that is std2 structure variable. But here one thing we should make sure, that if when you are assigning the two different variables, okay, the when you are assigning from one structure contents from of one structure variable to be another structure variable, make sure that the new structure variable should be a structure variable of the given structure, that is student. See, if std2, if it is not a structure variable that belongs to a structure called as student, then you cannot assign the members of this particular variable to this particular variable. Make sure that std2 is also one of the structure variable. Okay, now for example, in this previous example, now I can assign whatever the values are there in D1, the structure variable, the same thing I can assign it to D2. Only this is possible when D2 is a structure variable of the same structure called as distance. D1 and D2 belong to the same structure, that is distance. Only when they belong to the same structure, then you can easily assign. So therefore, this time if you are writing the statement as D1, from right hand side I'm telling D1 is equal to D2, when you write, even D2 might contain 5, 6.5 value, and then even it will have a member structures like in terms of feet and inches. I hope you are able to understand. Moving on to the very important topic, that is the nested structure. What is this nested structure? Nested structure is nothing but a structure could be defined as a member of another structure. We call it as an nested structure. Now here, such a structure where one structure is embedded within another structure, usually we call it as nested structure. See, first thing is, a structure could be defined as a member of another structure. If you carefully observe, okay, here is a struct followed by a structure name called as room. Look at its data type here. Its data type here we have given what? Distance, and then followed by the, that is the variable name as length. Then distance, variable name as breadth. So do we have any other data type known as distance? No, isn't it? But I am declaring this distance to be as a structure. Look at here, struct distance. What this distance consists of members as in terms of feet and inches. Therefore, if you clearly observe what we are doing here, the structure, one structure is embedded. This one structure is getting embedded within another structure. This concept actually we call it as nested structure. I'll repeat once again. So this is a structure. So this structure called as room contains another structure within into it called as the distance. Now distance is again a structure here. So this concept, a structure could be defined as member of another structure. This concept is called as actually the nested structure, wherein this one structure is getting embedded within the another. Now within the room structure, the another structure called as a distance got embedded within to it. Such concept we call it as nested structure. But here one thing we should remember is whenever the nested structures are being used, okay, the definition of internal structure, okay, this one, the definition of internal, now distance is an internal structure, isn't it? The definition of this internal structure, this should be preceded the definition of an outer structure. Now room is an outer structure and the distance structure is an internal structure. We should see to that whenever we define any internal structure should be preceded with an outer structure. That we should take care. So here the definition of a structure, that is distance, actually precedes the definition of a structure called as room, because distance is an internal structure and room is an outer structure. I hope you are able to understand. Now based upon this, we shall see how do we need to, once again the different example I'll explain with a nested structure here. Now look at this one clearly. When you look at this first, okay, this is an structure called as student. Herein we have a member known as register number of type integer, then date of admission, DOA actually stands of date of admission, and DOB actually stands of date for date of birth. But look at its data type here, what it is, date as a data type, all right. And then marks of type integer. Now integer is a basic data type. When you look at this particular data type, it's a date data type. Now do I have any other definition of a structure called as date? If you clearly observe, yes, here is a structure called as a date, wherein we have the day number of type int, month of type character, year of type integer. So which will become an outer structure for me? Student becomes an outer structure and date becomes an internal structure. Therefore, the internal structure called as an date, the structure here should always preceded the definition of an outer structure. So the internal structure we should write for, we should have first the definition of it and then we should have an outer structure. So what is the concept here? It's again a nested structure, isn't it? So the structure, one structure could be an embedded within an another structure, embedded in the sense placed within an another structure. Now date is an a structure which is being placed within an another structure called as an student. This is nothing but embedded. I hope you are able to understand. Now herein, whenever if I want to access this member structure register number, if I want to read and if I want to print with the help of structure variable only, definitely. And here the structure variable I have created as std, isn't it? Now if you carefully observe, std, if I want to access or read or something, how do I write it? Std dot register number. And if I want to read the marks, std dot marks. What if I want to go for the date of birth? I cannot directly write as std dot date of birth. I can't do that. So in case of what happens, to access the day number of the admission, now in this date of admission I have a date of admission, in the sense we have a day number there, we should have a month and we should have an year. So therefore how do we write? Like std dot date of admission dot the day number, because its data type is date. Date of admission, if I want to access this member, it will see its data type, that is data. The control will go to the date. What all you can have here, the members, you can have day number, you can have month and you can have year. That is the reason std dot date of admission dot day number. Then std.dateofadmission.month, std.dateofadmission.year. This way you can access. Similarly, when it comes to date of birth, if you want to print, again std.dateofbirth.daynumber, std.dateofbirth.month, std.dateofbirth.year. This way you need to access the nested structure. I hope you are able to understand. Now let me explain this one with a programming example so that you can have a clear picture. Now here is a program that is in order to read and display the student information by using a concept called as a nested structure. Now if you carefully observe here, we have an nested structure concept, but here date acts as an internal structure, date act as an internal structure and student act as an outer structure. Now outer structure I have written it in the main function and the internal structure I have written before the main function. For us, what it is, the definition of an internal structure should precede the definition of an outer structure irrespective of the main function. You can, before the main function also you can write the struct student, there is no problem. But anyway, we are following the rules here. Now, as I've already, now here if you carefully observe, the structure variable is yes, right? Now, see here, enter the name of the student. Now, I'm using the getLine function which belongs to a header file known as IOStream. And I know you have thorough with what is the difference between reading the contents with only with the scene and the getLine function. So, how do I read the contents for the name here? That is s.name,15. Now if you, why did I just only write s.name? Because it's data type, it's character, it's a fundamental data type, so we don't have any embedded structure here. Therefore, simple, as previous examples we have discussed, the same way with the help of structure variable and with the help of member or access operator, that is dot operator, followed by your member name followed by its size. This is how we are going to read the contents of the name. Next, if you observe, enter the register number. When it is asking for enter the register number, again it is s.register number, isn't it? That is the structure variable followed by the member name. Now when you observe here, enter the date of admission of the student. See how I have to answer here. Yes dot, what is your member name there? Date of admission. Yes dot date of admission. When you look at this, what its data type is? Date. Date is another structure. So the control will go to where you have written the structure of a date. So it comes here. What are the members? Day number. Therefore, yes dot date of admission dot day number. First it will read. Next, again stream extraction. Yes dot date of admission dot month. Similarly, yes dot date of admission dot year. Like this, day number, month and year will be read. After that, we are going to print whatever the information has been read as the student information. Then we are printing the register number. Okay. So in which variable we are having? So s.register number, the same thing I need to print it here. Then name, s.name, right? Date of admission. So when you are printing the date of admission, you want first it to be printed with the day number, then month and the date of admission, that dot year. So this way we are going to print it. Let me show its execution. Here, this is the same program what we have discussed. All right. Now let me compile this. Zero errors. And let me run the code. Now it is asking you to enter the name of the student. I'm going to enter as Rahul. All right. Then it is asking me to enter the register number. I'm going to enter this as register number. And now it is asking me to enter the date of admission. So I'm going to enter the date of admission as 25/5. Okay. 2021. Like this, I'm going to enter the date of admission. Now look here, student information, the register number as 1234, the name as Rahul and then the date of admission is 25/5/2021. I hope students you are able to understand. So this is how we are going to use the nested structure. So few of other some programs are there that we shall discuss in our next class. Stay safe, students. Thank you.